Hi, I'm Maddie from Me, You, and the Blended Crew, and I'm here to share 8 tips on how to develop a good relationship with your significant other's children. For those of you that aren't familiar with my vlog, we're a New York City-based family that consists of 2 divorced parents with children in different age groups from prior relationships. I have a 23-year-old son, a 20-year-old daughter, and a 13-year-old son. Randy, my significant other, has a 9-year-old daughter and a 5-year-old son. So between the two of us, we have 5 children in different age groups. Now, the older two, the 23-year-old and the 20-year-old, they're not really much of an issue. They're independent. They only come around when they're hungry, and their needs are different. So our main concern is the younger ones, the 13-year-old, the 9-year-old, and the 5-year-old. So when you decide to date someone with children, it's an adjustment because you're not just dating one person, you're dating all of them. And in the beginning of the relationship, initially, you keep the children out of it while you're getting to know each other, but eventually you will want to know the children. I mean, if the relationship is becoming serious, then, you know, you will eventually meet the children, and they will become the determining factor on whether the relationship will work or not. Because it's not that he doesn't love you or appreciate you, but he'll never love you and appreciate you more than his children. So if for some reason you don't hit it off, then guess what? The relationship isn't going to work. And I mean, you wouldn't want to be with someone that wouldn't put his children first anyway. So far, I have established a caring bond with Randy's children, and I did a lot of research because I wanted to get it right. And this is what I discovered, and this is what I've implemented in my relationship, and I feel this is what is working for us. But number one, give it time. Do not expect them to instantly like you. You're a stranger to them. Children can often feel confused about how to feel about you. Give them time to sort out their emotions, and don't take their behavior or anything they say to you too personally. They're children, after all. You're the adult here. Number two, allow them quality time without you. I know that initially when you meet the children, you're excited, you want to do things together, and you know, you just want to get the family vibe going. And that's good. You can do certain things together. But remember that before you got there, it was just them. You are someone new to them. As well-intentioned as you may be, the children may not receive this well. They're not used to sharing their attention with another person, especially a stranger that they just met. You don't want to infringe on their quality time together, because then they will start to compete with you and they will resent you if daddy's showing you too much attention. This especially if he has a daughter, because daughters tend to be a little bit more possessive. This is because daddy's their first love. This is the first man that a little girl falls in love with, and this is the person that teaches them how to love. And here comes this other female. It can become territorial, and you don't want that. So step back and let them have their time together. Honoring them by giving them back this exclusive time will help them respect you and maybe even miss you. Number three, accept that they will be loyal to their parents. Children are often emotionally torn when they enjoy time with their biological parents' significant other. They may feel guilt or disloyal, and they may hold back. Here's what I've done to help them deal with that struggle. allow them to keep their loyalties and encourage anything that helps them feel this. Like, for example, Dee Dee, Randy's daughter, she wanted to make something for her mom's birthday. So I took that opportunity to support her loyalty. Together we went to the craft store and we bought material to make her mom some barefoot sandals. Her mom was going away. She had mentioned this. She wanted to give her something that she made. And so we searched a YouTube video and together we made some beautiful sandals. And she was so happy. We packaged it, wrapped it, and she took it to her mom. And her mom was grateful also because it was a nice gesture. This is how you can support their loyalties so that they don't feel uncomfortable with the fact that they love their biological mom. As simple as that sounds, for a child, they're still struggling with understanding what your role in their life is and where their loyalty lies. So you must encourage them to remain loyal to their parents. By having a relationship with you and caring about you doesn't mean that they're disloyal. Something as simple as that made her so happy. And it also allowed her to show her mommy love freely. Number four, do not speak negatively or criticize their biological parent. That is a huge no-no. So think about it. Would you be okay with anyone speaking negatively or criticizing your parent? No. Not their mom, not their dad, period. Besides, doing so will sabotage their opinion. Number five, do not try to replace their mother or father. Don't. Children are fiercely loyal, so don't do it. In the beginning of my relationship, on more than one occasion, people assumed that they were my children biologically. They would see me, they would see Randy, they'd see all the kids, and you know, people being friendly or saying something would address me as their mom. And sure enough, one of them would clear that up with, she's not my mom. What are you gonna do? They're kids, they're honest, they're gonna say the truth. They don't mean anything by it. They're just being loyal and also being honest. So stay in your lane and consider yourself an added parent figure in the children's life. It's okay. Number six, let the children set the pace. If they are ready to open up and want affection from you, give it up. Don't leave them hanging. Regardless of what your relationship is with their biological parent, like with their mom, that should determine the relationship with you and the child. If the child wants to get closer to you, then welcome it. It means that you're doing good and it's okay. It's okay to love the child. And it's okay for them to love you once they understand that they're not being disloyal by loving you. It actually is a very rewarding feeling. Now, if they're aloof and cautious, it's okay also. It just means that they're taking their time to process their emotions and how they feel about you. Don't force it. With time, increase personal involvement and affection. They'll slowly warm up to you if you make them feel like it is okay and you're consistent. Just be patient. Number seven, disciplining the children. This is perhaps the most confusing role for the significant other. Setting limits, teaching value, and enforcing consequences. Here's what I say, don't do it. If the children are misbehaving, then pull your significant other aside and just say, hey, you know, the kids, you know, can you say something or whatever, but don't you do it. That's not your role in this relationship. I mean, if you're left in charge and he walked away or she walked away and you're the adult responsible for them, and after he explicitly explains to them that they need to listen and behave, then, you know, if they're acting up, you know, tell them to stop and give them a timeout, but nothing too harsh. Leave that to their biological parent. Now, if your significant other is too lenient for your taste, or if the kids are acting up and, you know, you want to say something, then pull them aside and have a conversation. You can give them advice or maybe suggestions, but be very careful with this. Don't criticize his kids. Because remember the loyalty thing? You know, parents get defensive when other people tell them about their children. I know I do. I don't like other people telling me about my kids. So I make sure not to do that to anyone else. So be very careful. Do not criticize. Also, do not compare his kids to your kids. And my kids did this and your kids do that. Guess what? Kids come with their own personalities and they don't come with instructions. So what worked for your kid may not work for his kid. So refrain from that type of behavior. Don't tell another parent how to parent. You can make suggestions, but for the most part, exercise restraint, patience, and be very cautious on how you say things. Because we tend to notice things in other kids that we ignore in our own. And that's a big one. That can cause arguments, trust me. So monitor yourself and let him figure it out. Because that's part of being a parent. You learn as you go. So allow him the opportunity instead of trying to jump in and tell them what to do or whatever, and don't ever discipline his kids. That is not your job, not your role. There are too many negative parallels with the stepmom or the biological parent's significant other. You don't want to support that image. They're kids. They will grow up, and eventually their behavior will improve, hopefully. Just be patient. Look at the bigger picture. Number 8, relax and build. Once they've opened up to you, relax and build. Pay attention to their likes and dislikes. Ask them about their day. Go to their practices, their games, their recitals. Offer to help them if they have a project. Plan individual activities that encourage bonding. Share personal stories about your childhood. Let them know that although you're not their biological parent, you care for them and you support them, and they can count on you. And that will help them develop trust and bond in your relationship and your role in their life. I hope this was helpful. Let me know what your thoughts or questions are in the comments below. And if you liked it, give it a thumbs up for more. Take care.